नमस्कार विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, टुडे वी स्टार्ट द लास्ट पॉइंट इन द टॉपिक क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, दैट इज द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। आजच्या व्हिडिओ मध्ये आपण वर्ग समीकरण या प्रकरणाचा शेवटचा भाग पाहतोय, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशनचा दैनंदिन जीवनामध्ये कसा वापर करता येतो ते आपण पाहणार आहोत उदाहरणांच्या माध्यमातून। सो लेट स्टार्ट फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल। लुक हियर्स, देअर इज अ रेक्टेंगुलर ओनियन स्टोर हाऊस इन द फार्म ऑफ मिस्टर रत्नाकर राव ऍट तिवासा। तिवासामध्ये मिस्टर रत्नाकर राव यांचं एक फार्म हाऊस आहे आणि त्या फार्म हाऊस मध्ये कांद्याचं स्टोअर हाऊस आहे। व्हॉट इज ओनियन स्टोअर हाऊस अँड शेप ऑफ द स्टोअर हाऊस इज रेक्टेंगुलर। त्याचा शेप कसा आहे? रेक्टेंगुलर आहे। द लेंथ ऑफ रेक्टेंगुलर बेस इज मोर दॅन इट्स ब्रेथ by 7 meter. The length of rectangular base is more than breadth by 7 meter. त्या आयताकृती म्हणजे स्टोअर हाऊसचा जो काय बेस आहे तो बेस रेक्टेंगुलर आहे आणि त्याची लांबी किती आहे? इट इज अ मोर then its breadth by 7 meter. Breadth पेक्षा 7 meter न जास्त आहे. And diagonal is more than length by 1 meter. आणि diagonal जो आहे तो length पेक्षा 1 meter न जास्त आहे. Find length and breadth of the stores of the storehouse. आपल्याला काय करायचं आहे? स्टोअर हाऊसची लांबी आणि रुंदी काढायची आहे. सो हाऊ टू फाइंड आउट? सो लुक हियर्स, वी स्टार्ट सोल्युशन ऑफ दिस एक्झाम्पल्स फॉर अंडरस्टँडिंग। वी ड्रॉ हियर्स अ स्टोअर हाऊस दॅट इज अ रेक्टेंगुलर। सो सिंपली आय ड्रॉ दिस। सो दॅट इज आय ड्रॉ हियर्स, वी ड्रॉ हियर्स अ रेक्टेंगुलर ओनियन स्टोअर हाऊस अँड देअर इज गिवन length of rectangular base is more than its breadth by 7 meters. त्याची जी लांबी आहे ती लांबी रुंदी पेक्षा 7 मीटर न जास्त आहे. म्हणजे लांबी किती आहे हे सांगितलं पण रुंदी किती आहे ते सांगितलं नाही. वी डोंट नो युअर ब्रेथ ऑफ दिस रेक्टेंगुलर स्टोअर हाऊस. सो वी कन्सिडर हिअर्स ब्रेथ ऑफ दिस रेक्टेंगुलर इज एक्स मीटर. हाउ मेनी इट इज? X meter. So write this. Let the breadth of store house is equal to X meter. So I write here sir, breadth of this here sir, X meter. Then how many length? Therefore what is length here sir? Length of the rectangular base is more than its breadth by 7 meters. Therefore the length of rectangular base is more than its breadth by 7 meter. म्हणजे त्याची जी लेंथ आहे ती लेंथ ब्रेड पेक्षा 7 मीटर न जास्त आहे, मोर आहे. सो ब्रेड इज हियर एक्स मीटर. So length become here sir x plus 7 meters. So write here sir, therefore length of storehouse, I write only length is equal to x plus 7 meter. So denote here sir, that is the length. I write here sir length x plus 7. Then diagonal is more than length by 1 meter. Diagonal, त्याचा जो diagonal आहे तो diagonal किती आहे? More than length. लंबी पेक्षा 1 मीटर में जास्त है. सो लेंथ इज एक्स प्लस 7, देयरफॉर डायगोनल इज हाउ मच इट इज एक्स प्लस 7 प्लस 1, दैट इज एक्स प्लस 8 मीटर. सो आई राइट हियर सम, देयरफॉर डायगोनल्स इज इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस 7 प्लस 1 मीटर. सिंपली आई राइट हियर सम एक्स प्लस 7 प्लस 1, दैट इज 8 मीटर. सो एज लाइक वी ड्रॉ हियर सम लेंथ, ब्रेथ एंड डायगोनल्स, आई डू नॉट हियर सम डायगोनल इन दिस फिगर. सो इट इज अ एक्स प्लस 8, हाउ मेनी इट इज एक्स प्लस 8. Now we calculate here length and breadth of the stores. आपल्याला काय करायचं, लेंथ काढायचं, ब्रेथ काढायचं. Now observe figure. How to draw length and breadth? So in this figure, you see here, sir, that is a rectangular base and this is the right angles. This is a rectangular base and in that we draw here, sir, diagonals. So what is this become here, sir? Right angle triangles, because this angle is here, sir, right angles, because every angle of rectangulars is a right angles. So this triangle become here, sir, right angle triangles. And we know here, sir, property about right angle triangles, how to draw diagonals, one side, second sides. So that is the Pythagoras theorems. By using Pythagoras theorems, we write here one step. So what is here, sir? By Pythagoras theorems, I write here, sir, by Pythagoras. By Pythagoras theorems, what we write here, sir? Look here, sir. This one diagonals, this is the one side, this is second side. So one side square plus second side square is equal to diagonal square. So I write here, sir, one side, that is the x square, plus second side, that is the x plus 7 bracket square is equal to diagonal square, that is the x plus 8 square. So as like we get here one equation. Now simplify this. It is very simple. So first term is your x square. It is the same. I write here, sir, x square plus in bracket x plus 7 bracket square. So that is the identity a plus b bracket square. You know this. By using this, we apply here, sir. I write here, sir, that is the a plus b bracket square is equal to what is identity? A square plus 2ab plus b square. So by using this, we expand. So first term here, sir, x plus 7 bracket square. For this first term, we write here, sir, x square. So write here, sir, x square plus 2ab. That means, sir, 2 into x into 7. So 2 into 7, that is a 14, 14x. So write here, sir, 14x. Plus for this b square, that is a 7 square. How many 7 square? That is a 49. Is equal to, again we expand here, sir, x plus 8 square. So as like same here, sir, I write here, sir, x square plus x into 8 into 2, that is a 2ab. So right here, sir, 2x into 8, that is a 16x. So right here, sir, 16x plus b square, that means 8 square. So right here, sir, 8 square, how many it is? 64. So as like we expand, so as like we simplify this equation. Now solve this. Look here, x square plus x square, that is a 2x square. I write here, sir, 2x square, and take this x square on that side, that is become minus x square. Then 14x and this 16x, write first here, sir, plus 14x. and this is 16x. You take on left side of the equals, so it becomes minus 16x. Then you take here so plus 49, and then this is a plus 64. You take on the left side of the equation, that is a minus 64. Now what is remaining here, sir? You take all this term on the left side of the equation, on the left side of the equal signs, so it becomes here, sir, is equal to 0. Now again simplify this. Look here, sir, 2x square minus x square, that is a single x square, plus 14x minus 16x. So how many is it, sir? It is a minus 2x. Then plus 49 minus 64. How many is it? So it is a, look here, sir, 49 minus 64. Simple subtractions. You know this here, sir. You get here, sir, minus 15 is equal to 0. So you get here, sir, equation x square minus 2x minus 15 is equal to 0. This is the quadratic equation. What is this? Quadratic equation. So look here, sir. We take here one example, that is the theoretical examples. This example we convert in quadratic equation. दिलेलं जे example आहे, शाब्दिक उदाहरण आहे, ते शाब्दिक उदाहरण आपण काय केलं, equation मध्ये convert केलं. Now we solve these equations and then we get here answer of this question, that is the length and breadth. So this is a quadratic equation. You solve any methods. There are factorization method, formula methods, complete square methods. Which apply as a factorization method. So look here, sir. That is the x square, that is the coefficient of x square is 1. And 1 into minus 15, that is the product is minus 15. And coefficient of middle term, that is a minus 2. So write here some minus 2. And we find out here two numbers. That means the product of these two numbers is a minus 15. And summation of these two numbers is minus 2. So which are they? So it is simple. We know here, sir, 5 into 3. 5 into 3, that is a 15. But we want here some minus 15. That means one of them is a negative and one of them is positive. So which are they? So it depends on sign of middle terms. Here sign of middle term is negative. So it goes on greater number, that is a 5. It becomes here some minus 5. And this 3 becomes here some plus 3. So these two numbers we get here, sir. Now you write this x square first term same as it is, then minus 5x plus 3x and this minus 15 same as it is. We write here, sir, for minus 2x, we write this 2, minus 5x plus 3x. Now solve this regular methods. You take your common x, x square minus 5x, what is common here, sir? You take here, sir, common x, and what is remaining here, sir? For x square, that is remaining only x minus in this 5x, so you take here, sir, x common, remaining here is 5. So write here is 5. Then plus 3 in bracket x 3x minus 15, you take a common 3. So what is remaining here? In 3x, you write here is 3, remaining here is x minus in 15. That is 15 is the product of 5 into 3. You take here is common 3. So remaining here is 5. So write here, sir, 5 is equal to 0. Now in these two terms, there is bracket is common. So write bracket first, x minus 5 in bracket, and then next term, x plus 3. So write here, sir, x plus 3 is equal to 0. Now separate this bracket. X minus 5 is equal to 0, or x plus 3 is equal to 0. Now solve this equation. X is equal to, that is minus 5, take on that side, it becomes plus 5. So x is equal to 5, or x is equal to plus 3, take on that side, become minus 3. So that is x is equal to minus 3. Now we get here, sir, two values for x. And x is a breadth of that rectangular storehouse. आपल्याला x च्या दोन किमती मिळाल्या आणि x म्हणजे काय आपण घेतलंय तर त्या स्टोरहाऊसची रुंदी घेतल्या, ब्रेड्थ घेतल्या. अँड वन ऑफ देम इज निगेटिव्ह, वन ऑफ देम पॉझिटिव्ह, सो विच आर दे? So we know here, sir, breadth of any rectangle is not negative. कोणत्याही वस्तूची रुंदी नेगेटिव नसते. कोणत्याही वस्तूची लांबी नेगेटिव नसते हे आपल्याला माहिती आहे. बट लेंथ इज नेवर नेगेटिव. देअरफोर एक्स इज नॉट इक्वल टू मायनस थ्री. देअरफोर एक्स इज इक्वल टू फाईव. देअरफोर वी राइट हियर सर, ब्रेथ इज इक्वल टू एक्स इज इक्वल टू फाइव मीटर्स एंड लेंथ इज इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस सेवन. दैट मीन्स फाइव प्लस सेवन इज इक्वल टू ट्वेल्व मीटर्स. सो एज लाइक वी सॉल्व हियर सर, वन थ्योरेटिकल एग्जाम्पल्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन द क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन. इन दिस एग्जाम्पल वी शेयर सर हाउ टू मेक क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन एंड सॉल्व दिस. We share some one more example, but before this, you write this. Now we share some next example on application of quadratic equation. So what is this example? A train travels 360 km with uniform speed. एक train travel करते, प्रवास करते 360 किलोमीटर विथ युनिफॉर्म स्पीड. सो व्हाट इज दिस 360 किलोमीटर? दॅट इज अ डिस्टन्स. राइट हियर द डिस्टन्स, देयर इज गिवन डिस्टन्स इज इक्वल टू 360 किलोमीटर. विथ युनिफॉर्म स्पीड द स्पीड ऑफ द ट्रेन इज इन्क्रीज बाय 5 किलोमीटर पर आवर्स. आता एका युनिफॉर्म स्पीड न ती काय करते, 360 किलोमीटर प्रवास करते. युनिफॉर्म स्पीड आपल्याला किती माहित नाही. द स्पीड ऑफ द ट्रेन इज इन्क्रीज बाय 5 किलोमीटर पर आवर्स. जे काय युनिफॉर्म स्पीड आहे ते इन्क्रीज केलं, वाढवलं, हा मिनी बाय 5 किलोमीटर पर आवर्स. तासी 5 किलोमीटरनं ते स्पीड वाढवलं. बघा 360 डिस्टन्स आहे तेवढंच आहे, एका विशिष्ट गतीनं ते जात आहे, एका विशिष्ट स्पीडनं ती प्रवास करते. पण स्पीड जर 5 किलोमीटर पर आवरनं वाढवलं तर काय होणार आहे? इट टेक्स 48 मिनिट लेस. 48 मिनिट काय करणार आहे? लेस, कमी घेणार आहे टू कव्हर द सेम डिस्टन्स. तेवढंच अंतर पार करण्यासाठी त्याला 48 मिनिट कमी लागतात. देन फाइंड द इनिशियल स्पीड ऑफ द ट्रेन. मग इनिशियल स्पीड किती आहे आपल्याला माहित नाही. सो फॉर दॅट द टर्म विच वी डोंट नो दॅट यू टेक युअर व्हेरिएबल्स. त्यासाठी आपण काय करतोय? व्हेरिएबल घेतो. सो राईट हियर सम, द इनिशियल स्पीड ऑफ द ट्रेन बी एक्स किलोमीटर पर आवर्स. सो राईट हियर सम, लेट द इनिशियल स्पीड of train is equal to x kilometer per hour. म्हणजे ट्रेनच आधीच जे स्पीड आहे ते किती आहे? x किलोमीटर पर आवर. देन वी राईट हियर डिस्टन्स. डिस्टन्स कव्हर्ड बाय ट्रेन इज इक्वल टू 360 किलोमीटर्स. आणि त्या ट्रेननं जे डिस्टन्स कव्हर केलंय ते डिस्टन्स किती आहे? 360. नाउ वी नो सर स्पीड अँड डिस्टन्स. सो व्हॉट इज फॉर्म्युला फॉर टाइम? यू नो सर टाइम इज इक्वल टू डिस्टन्स अपॉन स्पीड. टाइम इज इक्वल टू डिस्टन्स अपॉन स्पीड. So what is, you get here sir, time. So that is time become here sir, distance is equal to 360 and speed is here sir x. So various time. Therefore, time taken to cover the distance is equal to 360 upon x. 360 upon x. Now, the speed of the train is increased by 5 kilometers. Then we get as a new speed of the trains. Now, the new speed of train is equal to old speed is x, and this x speed is increased by 5 kilometers per hour. So new speed become here x plus 5 kilometers per hour. That time how many times? So that time is, therefore, time taken to cover the distance is equal to how many units? 360 upon x plus 5. So we get here two times. आपल्याला दोन टाइमिंग मिळाले. Now this time look here sir, it takes 48 minutes less to cover the same distance. म्हणजे तेच अंतर पार करण्यासाठी त्या ट्रेनला 48 मिनिट कमी लागतात. So that is a 48 minutes. How many it is? 48 minutes. So this is the difference between these two times. हा जो 48 मिनिटचा कालावधी आहे तो कालावधी म्हणजे काय डिफरन्स आहे कशामधला या दोन्ही टायमिंग मधला फर्स्ट अँड सेकंड टाइम मध्ये तो डिफरन्स आहे अँड इट इज इयर्स 48 मिनिट्स सो फर्स्ट 48 मिनिट कन्वर्ट इन अवर्स सो दॅट इज अ 48 अपॉन 60 अवर्स सो बाय गिवन कंडिशन देअरफॉर फ्रॉम गिवन कंडिशन We write here equations. So what is condition here, sir? Time taken to cover the distance 360 upon x plus 5. It is less by 48 minutes than previous time. म्हणजे तुम्हाला हे जे डिस्टन्स मिळालं 360 upon x plus 5, it is less 48 minutes. But whose? The time taken to cover the distance, that is 360 upon x. So we write here equation as like, sir. New timing 360 upon x plus 5, that is the new timing, is equal to, it is less by 48 minutes than old timings. How many old timing? That is the 360 upon x. It is less, so we write here some minus, but how many is it? So 48 minutes, but this 48 minutes we convert in hours, that is the 48 upon 60 hours. So write here, so 48 upon 60 hours. So that is the equation we get here, sir. So in that equation, look here, sir. Again, I explain this. That is the 360 upon x plus 5. That is the new timings when you increase the speed of this train by 5 kilometer per hour. ज्यावेळी तुम्ही ट्रेनचं स्पीड 5 किलोमीटर न वाढवताय त्यावेळी तुम्हाला लागलेला कालावधी किती आहे 360 upon x plus 5. And it is less 48 minutes, but whose? Kunapiksha. That is the time taken to cover the distance, that is uniform speed. Uniform speed na lagilo to kalavaji kya kalavaji piksha. 48 minutes na kami hai. So that is the uniform speed 360 upon x. So that is the time. So 360 upon x. It is a minus, it is a less. How many less? 48 minutes. But these 48 minutes you convert in hours. So we get here, sir, 48 upon 60. So that is the equation we write here, sir. Now you simplify this. आता आपल्याला काय करायचं आहे सिंपलीफाय करायचं. So how it simplify? Look here, sir. I write here, sir, these terms, these sides and this term, these sides. मैं काय करतोय ही जी टर्म आहे मायनस 48 अपॉन 60 राइट इन दिस सेट्स. सो राइट हियर सो 48 अपॉन 60 इज इक्वल टू दिस 360 सेम एज इट इज 360 अपॉन एक्स सेम एज इट इज एंड दिस टर्म राइट हियर सो माइनस 360 अपॉन एक्स प्लस 5. We write this equation as simple. Take this minus term on this side. So it becomes 48 upon 60 is equal to 360 upon x, that is same as it is. And this term is 360 upon x plus 5 take on that sides. Now change the sides. अपन क्या करते हैं side change करते हैं. ये जी side है इक्वल लेते हैं 360 upon x minus 360 upon x plus 5 is equal to write this side 48 upon 60. Again we simplify this. Look here sir, there is 360. So we take this common. Write here sir 360 commons. And in bracket what is remaining here sir 360. If you take here sir 360 commons, so remaining here sir 1 upon x. So write here sir 1 upon x minus this 360 you take common remaining here so 1 upon x plus 5. So write here so 1 upon x plus 5 is equal to 48 upon 60. Now take this 360 on that side. It becomes a divide. Write here so 1 upon x minus 1 upon x plus 5 is equal to this 48 upon this 60 into take this 360 on that sides. Now simplify this again. So take 1 upon x minus 1 upon x plus 5. So our variable is in a denominators. So for that, in a taking numerators, in the place of numerators, we take cross multiplication of this. So 1 into this bracket, 1 into x plus 5. So write here, sir, 1 into x plus 5, that is a x plus 5. This minus signs, x into 1, that is a x. Upon, take the multiplication of the denominator, that is a x in bracket x plus 5 is equal to, simplify this, 48 upon 60, that is a multiple of 12. So you get here sir 12 into 4 that is a 4 and 12 into 5 that is a 5. So 4 upon and this 4 we get here sir 4 upon 360. So these 4 divide this 36 you get here some 9. So 4 ones and 4 nines this is a 90. So in a numerator there is remaining only 1. Upon in a denominator 5 into 90. So 5 into 90 that is a 450. So right here sir 450. But now the bagaita apan kay kilo 48 ahe. Ita 60 ahe. Ita 360 ahe. 40 and 60 la apan kay kilo 12 na divides kilo. 12 na divide kilo na 3 ita 4 alo ita 5 alo. Again this 5 it is a multiple of 360. So you divide 4 by this 360. So 4 1 is 4. And 4 9 is 36 and take this 0 it becomes a 90. So you get here sir in a numerator there is only 1 and in a denominator 5 into 90. So 5 into 9 that is a 45 and this 0 take same as it is. So 1 upon 450 you get here sir. Now simplify here sir that is x minus x get cancels in a numerator remaining only 5. न्यूमरेटर मध्ये काय राहिलं फक्त 5 शिल्लक राहिलं x minus x get cancels. Now x in this brackets multiply this x into x x square x into 5 that is a 5x is equal to 1 upon 450. Now again for simplification you take care cross multiplication. So what is there so 5 into this 450 5 into 450 how much it is look here sir 450 into 5. So 50 become 5. 50 become 0. 5 into 5. 25. I write here. So 5 take to borrow. And 5 into 2. That is a 20. And take borrow here. Yes, 22. So that is the product here, sir. 2250. इज इक्वल टू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस फाइव एक्स इंटू वन, दैट इज सेम एज इट इज एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस फाइव एक्स. Now simplify this equation here, sir. I take this 2250, take on this sides, it become minus. And we get our new quadratic equation, that is x square plus 5x minus 2250 is equal to 0. So we get here a new quadratic equation. Now you solve this any method, formula method or factorization method or complete square methods. But we solve here by factorization methods. Look here, so draw your factor of this here, so minus 2250. That is the product, because here so coefficient of x square is 1 and middle term, that is a 5. So you find out here two numbers having product is 2250 and sum is a 5. So which are they? So these numbers are 50 and 45. I write here, sir, 50 and 45. But we want here, sir, product is a minus. So one of them is a minus. So, but who? So, look here, sir, for middle term, there is a plus sign. So, this plus sign you write for greater number, that is a plus 50, and minus sign you write it for 45. So, look here, sir. We get here two numbers, plus 50 and minus 45. So, we factorize this directly. So write this here, sir. X square then plus 50x then minus 45x and this term here, sir, minus 2250 is equal to 0. Now make pair of, that is first pair, that is second pair. What is common in first pair? So there is only x is common. So write here x. In bracket, what is remaining here, sir? In this x square, you write here x, remaining here, sir, x plus in 50x, you write here, sir, x, remaining only 50. So write here, sir, 50. And then here minus minus. So write here minus common. In 45x minus 2250. What is common here, sir? 45 is common, because the factor of this number is 50 and 45. So 45 is common here, sir. So write here, sir, 45, and in bracket, what is remaining here, sir? X. This minus minus here, sir, out of the bracket you write here minus. So in bracket it become plus. So 2250, the factor of these numbers is 50 and 45. So you take 45 common here, so remaining here is 50. So right here is 50 is equal to 0. Now take common brackets x plus 50, x plus 50. Right here, so bracket common x plus 50. And in second bracket you write remaining terms x minus 45. So right here, so x minus 45 is equal to 0. Now solve this. Separate this bracket. X plus 50 is equal to 0 or x minus 45 is equal to 0. Now solve this here, sir. X is equal to this plus 50, take on that side, become minus. So it get minus 50, or x is equal to, that is a minus 45, take on that side, becomes a 45 plus 45. So right here is a 45. So you get here, sir, two values of x. One is negative, one is positive. But we take which? But x is here, sir, initial speed of the train. X is initial speed of the trains. So speed is always positive, not negative. So we take here, sir, x is equal to 45. So write first here, sir. But speed, the speed is never negative. Therefore, x is not equal to minus 50. Therefore, x is equal to 45. But speed is never negative. therefore x is not equal to minus 50, therefore x is equal to 45. Therefore, what do you write here? The initial speed of the train is 45 km per hour. Therefore, the initial speed of train is equal to 45 kilometers per hour. So, as like we share so two examples depending on application of quadratic equations. तर आजच्या व्हिडिओ मध्ये आपण क्वाड्रॅटिक इक्वेशनचं ऍप्लिकेशन रोजच्या व्यवहारामध्ये कसं करता येतं ते उदाहरणाच्या माध्यमातून पाहिलं आहे. नाउ यू सॉल्व प्रॅक्टिस सेट 2.6. हाउ मेनी प्रॅक्टिस सेट 2.6 देअर आर गिवन एज लाईक एक्झाम्पल. यू सॉल्व दिस एक्झाम्पल. फर्स्ट यू मेक युअर क्वाड्रॅटिक इक्वेशन, देन यू सॉल्व इट्स. तुम्हाला काय करायचं आहे, प्रॅक्टिस सेट 2.6 सोडवायचं आहे. त्याच्यामध्ये अशाच प्रकारची उदाहरणं आहेत. सुरुवातीला तुम्हाला क्वाड्रॅटिक इक्वेशन तयार करायचं आणि मग ते सोडवायचं आहे. फक्त प्रॅक्टिस सेट 2.6 तुम्हाला सोडवायचं नाही, तर प्रकरण इथं तुमचं संपते. त्यामुळे तुम्हाला आणखी काय सोडवायचं आहे, प्रॉब्लेम सेट 2. व्हॉट यू सॉल्व युअर प्रॉब्लेम सेट 2 सुद्धा सोडवायचा आहे. तर आजच्या व्हिडिओमध्ये आपण आज इथं थांबतोय. आपण पुन्हा भेटतोय नवीन व्हिडिओमध्ये नवीन प्रकरण घेऊन. तोपर्यंत सर्वांना धन्यवाद. बाय बाय. सी यू वन्स अगेन. बट बिफोर दिस यू राईट ऑल दिस. देन धन्यवाद. बाय बाय. सी यू अगेन.